myself Sangeeta Devi from JK Jain School Raipura. To have a more update on our educational videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel JK Jain School. And if you like our videos, just like on it. We move on to the chapter 11 employee selection process. We were discussing in the last session also about it. We have completed 4 steps in the employee selection. The first step, it was the application blank. And the second step, it was the scrutinizing the applications. And the third step, we were having the selection test. And the selection test was categorized into 2, where you have the ability test and the next was the personality test. And in that, we have seen many number of testers. And in the last class, we were seeing the interview. In the interview, we have discussed about 10 types of interview which is conducted in an organization. It is not compulsory to have all those interviews, but few interviews will be conducted to the candidate choosing. So now we move on to the further steps we have in the employee selections. We have around 9 steps. The 5th steps we will want to see, because 4 steps we have completed. Now 5th step is the physical examination. In the physical examination, what is physical examination? First thing, we will have a medical fitness, collect the medical fitness from the candidate. Why we are getting this medical fitness? Because he wants to go to the doctor and prove that he is fit to be the candidate. Why that is necessary? Because if you choose the unfit and who is not healthy, candidate is not there, then we are recruiting him. After recruiting, 10 days he is working in the organization and he fallen sick. And again, it is the organization turn needs to be recruit the other person. So it is a waste of a time and a cost also. So in order to avoid all those things, this medical examination is conducted. Medical examination is nothing. A doctor needs to give a medical fitness certificate to the candidate that he is a healthy person. So in order to avoid that, when he fallen sick also, the cost and the time is waste for the organization and as well as for the candidate also. For that reason, we are getting the medical fitness, that is the physical examination. Next, we move on to the reference check. In the application bank itself, you will have the one column, that is a reference. Name and contact number needs to be given in that. Reference of 1 or 2 persons, they will ask. It depends on the organization. Some persons will ask 1 reference number, some will ask 2 reference number. Why they are asking this reference number is that to know the character and conduct and attitude and behavior wise of the candidate, this reference or name and the number is collected. Some organization will contact the person directly, will call them and ask the character wise and conduct of the candidate and have the result from the referent person who has a reference number given, from them they will get it. Some other organization, what they will do is they will have a standardized form. In that standardized form, it will be given to the referee, that is whose reference the number is given to them, it will be given. They need to fill up and they need to write about the candidate in that. After receiving it, whether if he is proving the having a good conduct, definitely he will be chosen in the organization. So that it in the application step itself, that is the first step itself, you will have this column. Reference, contact number and name needs to be provided. That may be your neighbor or your friends who is working in the other organization. It may be of any person. But that needs to be filled up in the application blank itself. But that will be used at the step number 6. For to know the conduct and behavior of the candidate, it used. Okay. Now we have the 7th step. Approval by higher authority. After moving all those steps in the employee selection process, we received applications and scrutinized it, a test conducted, interview conducted, and references being verified. Everything is over. At this stage, it needs to have a list of candidate who has chosen. HR will be choosing of the candidate. After choosing the list, it will be given to the higher authority. Higher authority in the case like a chairman, MD, or CEO, it may be of any person. It depends on the educations or the institutions or organization. It differs on the organization wise. It will be provided to the higher authority, the list of candidates, along with the waiting list candidate also. That person also will be given some importance. So that after having approval, okay, this person, certain persons we have selected, and 10 posting is there, whether we can provide them the job or not, it needs to be collected from the HR. HR will get it from the approval by the higher authority. That will be the step number 7. We move on to the 8th step, is the final selection. Final selection is also can be called as the final interview. Final interview where the selected candidate and who has got approval, that those candidates will be called for the final interview. In the final interview, the company or the organization will tell the rules and regulations of their company, policies, rules, regulations, and what needs to be done, and their job and job roles and responsibilities. Everything will be told in the final interview. After telling all those points from the company side, they ask the candidate also to have any discrimination you have from your side, you can tell to us. Like that, they ask the questions. So after having the final selection, whoever is okay with that, they will be going for the next step in the employee selection process. Where we have the last step in the employee selection process is the contract of employment. In the contract of employment, they receive, will be having an offer letter or a job joining letter will be there. In that, it will have a number of details. What and all the details it will be having? First, it will be having a job title. For what post he has been recruited. And date of joining, it will be there. In which date they will need to join. Date of joining will be there. And salary. Salary and other elements. Whatever the other benefits. Like we have a paper size. So what are the other perks it has. That will be mentioned. And it will have the other insurance or the any other policies is being given to the candidate. Or any claims is there. Like education fees of the children or any other details also will be given. And their main roles and responsibilities. We have a few more points also. And it will have the sign of the higher authority in that. And you as the candidate who has chosen, they also needs to sign. So it is the last step in the contract. Where the company give an offer letter or a joining letter to the candidate, and it will have all those details in that letter, and if the higher authority of the organization will sign, at the same time the candidate needs to sign. Thereby the employee will be get placed in the office or a company. So these all these steps we have in the selection of a candidate. From the beginning we have started with the application blank, when application is given to it, and scrutinizing was there. And after that we have a selection test, and we have moved on to the interviews conducted. And in today's class we saw about the physical examination that we are getting from the candidate, and reference checking, and we are getting verified that our candidate is very good conduct or not, and approval by the higher authority. And then final selections will be there. Final selections in the case they will be called for an interview, and the rules and responsibilities will be told to them orally. And in the contract of employment, it will have all those details. And in the details, both the organization as well as the company will sign in it. And now we move on to the next topic, factors affecting selection process. In this topic, we are having the 5 different factors which is influencing the selection process. What is the factors influencing selection process? First thing, we have a selection process that only we discussed in the last few sessions also onward. We have a 9 selection process we have. In that selection process, what are the factors or something which is disturbing or something which is influencing the selection process? We have a 5 topics. One by one, how they are disturbing or how they are influencing, we will see. First one, we move on to the nature of a post. Nature of the post is that, for the if it like small example I'll give you, we are taking a PO in a bank, that is a probationary officer, we are taking a bank, and we are choosing some salesperson in a office. Whether they are same, no, it is a different. So for the different post, the selection process is also different. If it is for the PO, how of a PO of a bank, if I am choosing, same procedure can be followed for a salesperson? No, the test it is conducted for the PO, it is different, or the interview conducted for the salesperson is different. So for the posting wise, the selection process is also differing. For the sales, person we will have a stress interview. For the PO of the bank, it is necessary to have a stress interview? No, it is not necessary, but it may have it also. So it for the post wise, it is differing. The selection process is getting affected. So that was the first reason we have in the factors influencing selection process. We move on to the next point, number of candidates. For some posts, we will have more number of candidates, like 100 or 200 candidates also will be applying for a single post, like a clerical or physical jobs or not. More number of candidates we will have. If we have more number of candidates, it will be very difficult for the organization. They want to cut short all the unfit and unqualified candidates, and then only they can call up the other person. So for some number of candidates will be increasing depending on the post where we are giving. It is somewhat interrelated with the both. Why? Because based on the post we are giving, like a clerk we want, more number of candidates will be applying. For if you are using a senior accountant or some person which is a higher authority, only few of them will apply. So depending on the post, the number of candidates applying will differ. If they are applying more candidates, and definitely it will be a difficult one having a selection process. First they want to cut short into, from 200 they want to cut short into 50 or 100, and then they need to conduct interview for the 50 or 100 person, and from them only the other process can be moved on. So that, for the next one is the number of candidates influencing the selection process. Next is the selection policy. Selection policy differs from each. If you have a large scale or organization or medium or small, we have a different scale of operations. We have in that, in a different scale of operation, scale of organization, large, medium, small, the selection policy is also different. The large scale organization, if it is a highly popularized and having a good brand name of the company, definitely more number of candidates will apply. And in that situation, the selection policies also will be different. They will have more number of steps. If you go for the small companies, like if you go and you have only 2 or 3 round of an interview. If you go for the large, you will have 5 or 6 round of an interview. So depending on the size of the organization and their policy is also different. Policy in the case, the selection process they conduct. Like they will have 3, they may have 5, they may have 7 also. 7 steps also they can have. It depends on the size of the organization and the selection policy what they are following. What they are following in the case of what are the steps they are going to conduct. First they will receive applications. The organization needs to decide on the steps in the employee selection process. Next we have the cost factor or budget. Cost factor or budget is that when we have the length of the process, selection process. Length of the selection process in the case where we have more number of steps in selection, definitely the cost of for the conducting the interview or conducting choosing the candidate will be more. We may have a 5,000 or 10,000 being spent on the when we have the more number of steps. When we have a less number of steps, when I have 3 steps, the cost of what I'm spending on choosing the candidate will be lesser. I may spend 2,000. How this expenses are being made? Why I am telling these expenses? I am going to call a person. For what and all the expenses is that? You will have first need to give an advertisement in the newspaper or a television or the online website. First advertisement cost will be there. And then you need to have the telephone conversations or a video conference for that. And net charges will be there. So we have a more number of cost being spent on the selection process. So when we have a length of the selection process is more, the more amount we need. The resources of the organization will be spent more on this choosing a candidate itself. And we have a length of the selection process is lesser. We have only 2 or 3 steps. In that situation, I will spend the amount is will be lesser. That was the next factor influencing the selection process. Next, we move on to the level of educational qualification and experience. Today, I am planned to appoint, planned to have a vacancy of a senior accountant is going to retire. So, I want persons to be filled on that. In that situation, the experience, I will have the experience of more than 10 years only they need to apply. in that situation, only few application I received. More than 10 years experience, only few persons will be senior accountant, and that persons alone will be giving up their resumes or application they will be filling up. So the persons will be lesser when we go for the experience. And the level of education, qualification wise also it will differ. How it is differ? If I am choosing a club, I want a BCom or MCom student. So in that situation, more number of candidates will be there. If I go for the higher level, in the case like I want a manager or any other HR, I'll have the postgraduate. Postgraduate in the case, if I want postgraduate, only few of them will be the postgraduate. So in the level of education wise and the experience wise, the candidate will be lesser or higher, the selection process will be differing on it also. So if I have only 5 persons having the experience of more than 10, then among of them 5, one is easier to choose. If I have a BCom student of a clerk, I am going to choose, I have a 50 candidates. From them, choosing of 1 or 2 will be a difficult one. So it is, this process will be influenced by this level of education and experience wise also. So these are the factors influencing selection process. First one, we have thought about the nature of a post, in which post we are applying, due to that selection process is getting affected. Number of candidates, 100 or 200 or 10 or 5. Selection policy differs with the each level of size of the organization, large, medium, small. And cost factor, the length of the selection process. I have a 2, the amount spent will be lesser. When I have a 10, the amount spent on the choosing a candidate will be more. Next is level of education, qualification and experience. When I go for the higher level, only few persons will attend the interview. The process will be easier. When I go for the lower level of educational qualification people, then I will have a more number of candidates applying. There it will be a difficult one. So these are the factors influencing the selection process. Thereby I'll end the session. Thanks for watching.